People, welcome back to Politricks Watch. This is Sir P. Now, today I'm going to talk about the trial of the century. I'm talking about the biggest criminal trial. The biggest criminal gang trial in Jamaica's history. Matter of fact, I think it's actually the biggest of its kind in the entire region. We've never seen anything like this. 50 gang members, ranging from 87 to 90 octane, will take part in this trial. This has never been done before. This has never been seen. And it will be, I guess you could say, the poster child to what could possibly happen in the future. See, this trial, this is what Jamaican people need to understand, say. Even though you're not hearing about it, even though it's not hot in the press now, you need to understand, this trial is going to make or break legacies. Entire reputation will be built or destroyed based on the results of this trial. 50 members of the Klansman gang will be going before the courts one time. Now, before, we've seen trials before, for example, the Tesha Miller trial. That trial wasn't no trial of nothing. That wasn't even trial of the day, much less trial of the century. Why? Because if you listen to that video, you could tell I wasn't really that excited. Because Tesha Miller, behind bars, can still be Tesha Miller. Tesha Miller, or when normally when a Don drop a jail, sure, his body might be locked up, right? He might can't move around, but he still has access to phone. He can still send messages, he can still get the word out, and he can still get somebody dash away from behind bars. So, Tesha Miller going to jail, while symbolic, when they talk about a symbolic victory, yes, it looks good, sounds good, lack of the 30 years, fine. But guess what? Tesha Miller can still do everything in the Dwyer Road from his prison cell. Tesha Miller was also not the type of Don to go up on the streets day to day and a shootout with nobody. Tesha Miller was not a Sir D from Stone Crushers. He wasn't. He was a send out orders type of Don, which is what most Dons are. Most 90 octanes are send out orders. However, Ratos Kratos, the man who helped sink Tesha Miller, in my opinion, was a far more dangerous man than Tesha Miller. Far more dangerous. Now, Ratos Kratos claims him change him life, and he might tell people somebody must leave badness alone, and when he come back on road, we are going to see how true he was. We are going to see if his statements hold up, right? Ratos Kratos is a dangerous individual. His argument that he's doing it because so many lives were lost and all these things, well, time will tell. Time will tell. But the swap of giving Ratos Kratos 3 years for seeing Tesha Miller, even though I understand it, I fully understand the reasoning behind that. Fully, 100%. Right? Let me say, you see what them give Samuel Bull because they want to sing John Gotti. I fully understand it. Right? Tesha Miller is the figurehead, he's the face. When you sing him, people say yes, then get it done. However, we know that's not how crime works. We know sending the Don to jail does not stop a single thing. As a matter of fact, what it normally does is open up a power vacuum, and then other like 87 them now start fight for who become Don, and then things get even more violent. But this case, 50 one time. This trial will include Tesha Miller's no rival, Andre Blackman Bryan, from him straight down to his 87s, 50 of them. Now you see the importance, because this is not a case of, oh, we just lock up Blackman and give him 30 years, but then 49 of them soldier them still in the streets. No, we can now get Blackman and 49 of the Klansman soldier them. This is monumental, because if them 50 man they come back on road, you already know what gonna happen to Spanish Town. You already know what got happened to the place. You see, the government or the justice system cannot afford to lose this one. I know this is not mainstream news right now. I know it's not hot topic. And these are the type of videos that I realize only the core people in the movement actually watch and care about. Only the core people in the movement actually business about them kind of topic here, right? Because you see, these things, these events, as me say, help shape the future at the country. Now we've seen the whole Kings Valley Circus. I think I call it in a trial, Kings Valley Circus, right? How the man them end up bust the case. We could see how that one was going to play out. However, Kings Valley, in the grand scheme of gangs, Kings Valley is fairly small time, right? And the police have all the time to go out and catch them 111. But when you're talking about Klansman, you're talking about top three most violent and destructive gangs in Jamaica's history. And if you can get 50 of them, listen, when these trials go down, normally the justice system only have one star witness, right? That's how Kings Valley fall apart, because once them pull apart that witness, the case start to crumble. Now, in this trial, they haven't released any information yet about who them have or what, but knowing Jamaica justice system, it's probably one star witness, just one, or more, maybe two, right? I'm hoping, seeing as our 50 man, then can at least bring on 10 solid witness who we can work with. 10, that would be a good case, right? But again, we have to manage the expectations. Knowing them, I probably won. If that is the case, let me talk to the justice system. Let me talk to the DPP. Let me talk to the Minister of National Security. Whichever witness you have in this trial, you need to do whatever you have to do to make sure, say, this witness reach trial. Because we've seen it too many times. Witness agree, because just the fact that them go trial, tell we say them have one witness. They must have a witness, otherwise they're not going to trial. So, if you don't have a witness, whatever you have to do, whichever strings you have to pull it. If the witness tell you, say, him want jerk chicken and lobster, still trial, give it to him. If the witness tell you, say, him want one of them bed there, where when you lie down at night, it take the shape of your body and it make out a cloud and magic dust, give it to the witness. If a three witness you have and them tell you, say, listen, want one of them, the massaging seat, they will must give it to the witness then. Whatever the request is, just give it. Because me, I tell you right now, Jamaica will not forget. Sorry, let me change that. Those of us over here in the movement and like-minded Jamaicans will not forgive or forget if this trial end up like Kings Valley. If them Klansman are bust the case, I'm telling you, DPP just got an extension. You notice me not even comment upon that. Me never even comment upon the whole DPP getting extension. People say, sir, P, what you think? Listen, this is what. You may say make or break reputation. Miss Paula Llewellyn, me know you're supposed to down there. I pull your strings because you know how important this case is. And you know how legacy work is that people normally remember the biggest thing you ever do. And if that biggest thing was a failure, that's how you will be remembered. People are split when it comes down to the DPP. Some people say, oh, get rid of the DPP because she now did this. And people say, well, get rid of the DPP is doing the best she can. Listen, as usual, the answer is probably somewhere in the middle. It cannot be easy being the DPP in Jamaica. It simply cannot. There is nobody who's going to go into that seat and suddenly get all the answers and just start flinging a man at jail left, right, and center. It's none, right? There's been many instances where I've disagreed with some things that Paula Llewellyn do, but I have to be fair. The role of DPP in Jamaica is an extraordinary role. You're talking about one of the most corrupt societies with one of the highest crime rate on earth, okay? One of the highest murder rate. Nobody is just going to go into that seat and suddenly get all the answers, right? However, we are talking about legacy. Paula Llewellyn can shape her legacy if she sink these 50 Klansmen, especially if Blackman unite. If she can get rid of Blackman, if she can go down as a DPP, who build the case that got rid of Andre Blackman Bryan, who, as many said before, in my opinion, worse than Tesha, right? When it comes on to doing more destruction, right? We're talking about comparing criminals here, but we are just if you really ask people in the streets which one worse, then probably most people tell us the Blackman worse than Tesha, all right? No, Tesha the behind bars, fine. Now we can think Blackman and 49 other men. Because when Tesha got jail, him never got jail with 50 other Klansmen. That's when me that really celebrate. You see, if Ratos Kratos did sink Tesha and 50 other Klansmen, then me that say, you know what? Ratos Kratos, on the balance of things, it was worth it. It wasn't a one-to-one trade. The one-to-one trade that we do for Ratos and Tesha, listen, I'm really worried how that going to work out. I'm really worried how it's going to work out. What going to happen when Ratos come back on road? However, in this case, whoever the witnesses are, right, if I 2-3 witness them off, even if those witnesses were 87, if them can sink 50 man, including black man, then in my opinion, that is a very, very good deal. That is a deal that is worth it. That is a deal that the Jamaican public, in my opinion, should be able to accept. Fair trade. Especially for one or two man. If we can take one or two man and get rid of 50, including black man and some of the top soldiers that may work for black man, that's a good deal. That is a good deal. Right? Because right now, one of the reasons why black man can't get rid of him damage are because too much of him soldier them, they're behind bars. So there's very few people whom can call upon. Remember the brother them get killed over there in Olaba? Those were black man soldiers, right? Very few and far between. Black man don't really have much youth left in the streets. Enough people know that. Black man don't have a lot of youths, serious youths, who left in the streets. If they have some brother from over Riverly side there, so to, where them did find the shallow graves, if they have some brother over there, so to, but people, they might take time get out. They might take time get locked up. This is very important for Jamaica's future. Very important. Please, the witnesses must be protected at all costs. We don't want to hear say you can't find them, because that's another thing. Right before trial, you say, oh, you're on the NO, so we can't find the witness. Like the witness come from Mars and he's gone on a spaceship. Please, this have to work out. This trial have to work out. This is make or break. 50 man, one time, from Klansman. The only equivalent could have been 50 stone crusher. As I have said, top three most dangerous and destructive gang in Jamaican history. Just to talk to my core supporters them still, real people in the movement. You know the people them who are driven by excitement, matter what people them who are organized. Right? I only mean that reason. That's why if you notice my whole tone and you know my cadence, I just reason my reason like the whole hour sitting on the table. I just reason my reason, you know. We need this trial. We need this one for work. 50? One time? I don't know. I mean, some people might argue maybe it's better for break it up and say, I don't know. Do we even have, how the logistics of that even work? Well, we're going to see. It's going to be record breaking anyway, I take it. But we just put it out there that this one will not be swept under the carpet and just nobody now kiss them teeth and say, boy, I saw it go like with Kings Valley. There will be noise. If this case fall apart, there will be noise, man. I tell you that right now. Whole heap of noise, though. And we can see it work out, no? Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know. People, stay safe.